Shalom and greetings to all and all that accompany us this day today, and particularly to the Rastafari family. Shalom, Salamta. Now, we come to you from Southern California on Rastafari Fellowship channel on YouTube. Now, if we would willingly open up scripture to New Testament, to the Epistle of Paul the Apostle to the Romans, and if we direct ourselves to chapter 2, verse 5, we'll pretty much receive a summary, a sum up of everything that's taking place in the Noah days. Now, it reads, "But after thy hardness and impenitent heart, treasurest up to thyself wrath against the day of wrath and revelation of the righteous judgment of God." So it's what's taking place. We can behold, look and see the wicked them treasuring up to themselves a day of wrath against the day of wrath and righteous judgment of God, you know, and that day has come. Christ and his kingly character has been made manifest and has brought to light, resurrected the Son, Yeshua, HaMashiach, in his true humanity as Ethiopian, and totally discrediting and abandoning and obliterating the false concept, the false man idea, man-made image of a Caesar Borgia, or Kaiser Borgia, as a Christ type, or as Christ himself, as many would assume and make believe. Now, the reason we mention this is because the revelation of the righteous judgment has been manifest. That is Yeshua. He's the only righteous, and he is judgment. But because the wicked them wish not to receive the good news, they treasure up to themselves a day of wrath against the day of wrath. And that is the point that we are in currently. You see, many, many individuals predicted somewhat precisely, somewhat accurately, the coming of the man-child, Lich Teferi. But as they well predicted, the coming resulted in a great disappointment. Probably that disappointment was that Christ, Yeshua, was black and is black and will always be Ethiopian, right? And His Majesty is Ethiopian too. So that turned off a lot of people. And so it resulted in what is known as the Great Disappointment. And so quickly, it went from feast and celebration of the coming to a great disappointment and the end of the world. So, late 1800s, early 1900s, there's a shift from the coming of Christ to, man, Christ is black. So, forget that, we're not going to accept that, we're gonna be vain in our imaginations, we're going to be fools pretending and thinking ourselves to be wise, and we're just going to go ahead and treasure up amongst ourselves the day of wrath against the day of wrath, and let us pretend that the end of the world is to come. And so, these last 100 years, we've heard very little, if any, about any scripture, anything concerning Jesus Christus, Yehoshua, HaMashiach. All we hear is the end of the world, because to them, they gave up that opportunity. But, you know, for those willing and wanting, the revelation has, well, parts of revelation have been fulfilled. So, you know, if thou seekest a portion in truth, thou shalt have a portion of truth, but one must accept with all truth and sincerity truth, you know, if thou art of truth. Now, the reason we mention this is because this is going to kind of like spring over to another topic, but nonetheless it is somewhat relative, if not completely. Now, you know, a fellow brother, and first of all, we give thanks to the individual, because he taught I, and Jah willing, all the I them a lesson, and something that we are to honor and seek to do it ourselves. You see, we received a message, you know, giving us a heads up on potential event. On a potential event that is to come, and so we checked it out, and turns out, it's not the event itself, right, but the actual information and what is what is stirring this whole idea of an event up. The source of this idea is quite interesting, and the way that they present it is it's fairly. I mean, I gotta give it to them. It's really neat, really well organized, really well presented. It gives that sense of a spook to the unlearned, and in many cases it'll frighten, you know, the good out of many. And so, but we Rastafari have comfort in the Holy Spirit, and we know it, that which we are given to know, and we know for sure that all will be well, because let the word of Jah be true, and the ideas of man be vain. So, but more importantly than the actual, we'll get into what it was that we were informed on, but more important than that was the action. Now, regardless of the event taking place or not, or the significance or the gravity of the situation, or how important or how big or how small the matter was, the key point to observe and to learn from and to take as an example and to seek to walk in that way is how our brother was kind enough to give us a heads up. That means that he's on it, you know, he's on what we all should be on. We do not know what what might light the fuse, you know, what spark is going to ignite the fuse. And so that's even funny, because it has to do, fire has to do. But yeah, it's to say that we all got to be watchers, and we got to watch out for each other, because no one else will do it for us but ourselves, you know. And so we gotta keep that is to honor, you know, that is to that brings even more comfort, because it makes us know that there are brothers that are looking out for these kind of things, and we must look out for everything, because we don't know what's going to light the fuse, right? And so with that, let's make mention that, well, I think it's only a proper excuse that, you know, we're all over the place, but I think it's proper to mention what it was, and we are talking about this song. This, I think it's a movie. Prometheus Wayman Corporation, and it's pretty interesting actually. We saw one clip, and that clip, as a matter of fact, had to do with fire. How some guy stole the knowledge of fire from the gods and brought it to man, and this man claiming to be God, and that's gonna make everyone God. And so, I mean, whatever, that's foolishness, right? But nonetheless, it's not to say that these people aren't contemplating or treasuring up to themselves a day of wrath against the day of wrath. I mean, they're pissed. They're super upset, all right? So let's not take these things lightly. And if, I mean, even if nothing were to happen October 11, 2012, that completely doesn't matter. The fact that people are looking out for each other, better yet, a family is looking out for each other, that is what we are to observe. And but, you know, let us just, you know, make mention that since, being that this is a movie, and we'll get into that a little bit, but we just want to make, well, we're not going to find it, right, but, well, okay, we're not going to, spend time looking for it, but what we wanted to read was that since, you know, colonialism and all that wickedness, since the beginning, its foundation has been economic interest, and it is with economic weapons that these evils can and have been destroyed. And so let us not give power to something that is powerless, as far as, you know, to begin with, we're speaking about a movie. So the basis of that evil seeking to manipulate and enslave the minds of individuals and leave them in a state of frozen psychology, you know, without, you know, stunned and impaired of movement and fascinated, because people become fascinated and captivated by these movies, and they're left in a position where they can't move forward. So the basis of this is strictly economical, and it is with economic weapons that they have been destroyed, and we can destroy, and we will destroy. So let us not invest our economics on economical evil weapons. That's that. And also, you know, because they, you know, the wicked are planning a day of wrath against the day of wrath. That they have been, they've been planning all their lives, so let them keep planning. The only plans that have shown themselves to come to pass with all exactitude is Jah word, and so let that be that. But let us make mention to the wicked them, in case them be listening, and we know they are. We must put our faith in Him, in the Almighty Creator that is good, and He will not desert us or permit us to destroy mankind, humanity, in which He has created in His image. You know, it doesn't say here that He will not allow the wicked, false interpretations of mankind to destroy themselves. So take that in consideration. And plus, you know, putting this into context, He's addressing the leaders. He's addressing the leaders of the world, you know. You must remember that your faith are not entirely in your hands. And so Jah will not let I and I destroy that which He has created in His image. You know, it's not that we're trying to add to this, but I nowhere in there does it say that even the wicked them, you know, that which is not in the image